six volumes. They were thin, so the blue book. You know what I'm talking about?
I think so.
This will be the reading room. No?
I think so.
And you haven't seen it?
I have not seen
the reading room is in a fix by itself. And this kind of stuff, that's trash. It goes in the trash can. And we have stuff like that in the house, and it piles up. Then we can't find where we're supposed to be.
Okay.
Now, we're going to have to find those books, and we're going to have to read it. It was about six volumes of it, and I bought it from the Christian bookstore a long time ago, but the Christian bookstore was...
You bought those books when I was just coming out of Calvary Chapel back in 2003.
Mm-hmm. Well, I was laying in the bed and I was thinking, we haven't been reading about what the Bible says about sex and about babies and all kinds of stuff that we're supposed to be reading.
Those books was 13, am I saying it right? 2010, because that's when I was reading heavily about the anatomy and what system goes where and this and that and the other. That was the last time I remember seeing any of those books in 2010.
Have you seen them there? What you're supposed to be studying and learning and putting in your head, what you're supposed to be not. And you spend a lot of time looking at the Holocaust and what's that fool with that little mustache? Hitler and the World War II. You don't. And your sister has to know too. We got to dig. Just like those prayer books. On the page. There's no excuse for you not to have your prayer books and be reading them and praying. No excuse at all. If my mother bought me something, I couldn't say, "Oh, Mama, I don't know where it is. It just disappeared. I'm so bad with books." You think I'm stupid, though?
No, Mom, I don't think you're stupid.
Well, somebody think I'm stupid.
Nobody thinks you're stupid. But what I'm telling you, I'm really bad with books. And if I move something, the only way I don't lose a book is if I don't move it. That's the only way I know. That means I don't use it. Did you catch that?
No.
You should catch that.
Mm-mm. And books, a good book is important. That's why they, You have to keep the book. You got to know where it is. You read the book. You put the book back where you know. There's no excuse for that. I don't want to hear that. Because the only person that comes up ignorant and hurting because you don't have the information in your head from the book is you. Now, if that's okay with you.
I didn't say that was okay with me, Mom.
You make sure you know your generals and all them people.
Mm-hmm. I don't even know that stuff. I just use that to keep my brain sharp. Not really into that.
Well, you better keep your brain sharp on God's word. What you're supposed to keep your brain sharp on? You better keep your brain sharp on it. I ain't gonna be here too much longer. I was laying, trying to go to sleep, and it just kept running across my mind. I got stuff on the wall, just all through the house, and read this book, and this is, and we're supposed to take this kind of medicine. And y'all wake up. Me and Daddy are asleep in the bed, and everybody's supposed to be asleep at this time. Are they not taking enough calcium?
Okay. The sleeping stuff is another rigmarole in and of itself. I've never been able to get a sleeping schedule. The chamomile tea is a problem. The TV in the bag is a problem. So I just say, I'm just going to wait till everything goes off, and then I'm going to try to go to bed.
Let me tell you, that is not good. It's not good, Joshua.
Okay.
Get off of your feet. You're in here sitting at the table doing what? I don't know. When I get up to in the morning, when I go to that reading room, in that reading room, you got trash in there.
Wait a minute.
Empty bottles.
Mama.
What?
Okay, the first thing, you need to stop getting upset. The more you get upset, the more that makes me and Thea upset. And then if you wanted to teach me, I'm gone because you're upset. So.
Don't you think I ought to be upset?
Okay, let me say it again because you missed it. You want to teach me, keep your upsetness out of it. Because if it comes, I'm gone. Now,
don't you think I should be upset?
Okay, Mom. I'm going to ask you the big question. Do you want to really teach me?
I can't teach you nothing when the books disappear and the books is out of order and can't find the books in the reading room.
Okay.
What can I teach you? And I'm supposed to be nice and calm.
Okay.
And you want me to keep talking to you over and over?
Mom,
where are the books? Keep buying the books over and over
Mom,
again. And be calm.
I'm trying to say something, and you keep ranting like that. By the time you finally stop, I forgot what I was trying to get you to say. First off, you can't even understand, except the sad fact that your son is bad with books. Don't have him handling books until he finds a way to deal with it where he doesn't lose them. And at this point in time, the only way he knows not to lose a book is to not even use it. It's not because he wants to be ignorant, but because he knows he's so bad with it.
Come sit down, dear.
I know I need your information. That's one is good. I'm not getting it. Second is good. Then you get upset with me because I'm going to talk to you. I'm just discouraged everywhere along the line. And then you have another guilt trip question. Shouldn't you be? All of that just makes
me.
You're still doing it.
think I'm stupid.
You're doing it again.
Doing it.
I'm going to ask you a question, and then I'm going to go back to the main point.
No, you need to shut up. I'm the teacher, and I'm the teacher.
The way you're teaching me is making me run away.
You're right.
Mom?
Shut up! That's your papa. You get to show your mother, and you get to teach your mother, and you... Are you...
Do you want me to answer?
No.
Then why do you ask me a question?
Because you need to think about it. And I told you, when you said your feet was swelling, I suggest you need to get off your feet and you need to stay off the salt. Now that's a problem because I got to run that lesson by Daddy. But when he gets hungry, whatever's in the refrigerator, and he's already bought it anyway, he's going to eat it. And he's just going, I'm going to fix the sausage, and y'all can eat what you want to eat. And I said, oh.
Mama.
Like I'm supposed to go in the kitchen and fix something. So we have to fix what you want to eat. I do have books about that. We got about 6 volumes of it. Starts off where do babies come from and the church as your family. I said, oh my God, where are those books at?
Well,
do you see this stuff here? Do you see it?
Yes, Mom.
It don't move. It don't move.
Mom? Okay.
You know? No. You tell me about if you read a book, then it gets lost. Because the thing about it is, it doesn't have feet. It has no way of moving. It doesn't have muscles.
I know that.
You do?
Okay. Let me say something, and please take this. Stop talking to me like you think I'm stupid when I'm really trying to show you how smart I technically am. Now, I understand that books don't move on their own. When I say I'm bad with books, it means I do not have a sense system to put it at a specific place so I don't lose it.
Well, the specific place that we have at the house is in the reading room.
Okay. That reading room has been out of commission for...
That room don't move, and if you put something in that room, it's in that room.
That reading room has been out of commission.
What do you mean out of commission?
We haven't used the reading room like we were supposed to since I was a late teen.
Joshua.
Okay. I'm not jerking you around.
I wish you would shut up because that's all that comes out your mouth is a bunch of jerk. We haven't used that room since 1900, and what's in there?
I'm trying to tell you.
Nah. What's in there is stuff that you've been putting in there. Because if you left that room like it was, when me and Daddy cleared it out, and I set books in there, and VHS's and DVDs, it would be just like that. And you know you've been messing around in that room.
Mom?
Shut up.
Stop accusing me.
No, I have to accuse you because ain't nobody else done messed that room around for you.
I can tell you what I actually did with that room, but you don't want to hear that. And I can tell you.
What did I hear?
Okay, well, this is what is going on. This is what you see. And stop it. You need to shut up. You need to. Okay. I understand that I need to be taught, but I don't know how to say it to you. You've been telling me to shut up so much.
You're trying to say to me.
The way you're trying to do it.
The way I'm trying to do it.
See, right there.
You do it. You get tired of you trying to tell me how to do it.
This is what happened. I'm up here, can't sleep. Can I say what's going on, or are you just going to keep doing that? Okay. Oh.
Your mouth is too big. Do you know that?
All right, let me say this. When you say I'm going to shut up, you ain't going to get me to talk. And by the way, when that happens, I'm not going to be the one getting in trouble for it.
You got to be bad.
Mama.
Because if you don't talk, you have already done your stuff in this house.
Mama.
Shut up. Stop calling me Mama.
Stop accusing me.
I have to accuse you. You're the only one that I can't.
Alright, Mom, since you want to accuse me.
Yeah, I ain't accusing you.
It's the truth. I said you are accusing me, and I can tell you
it's the truth, Jonathan.
Yes, okay.